everyone? How's it going? Are you getting cabin fever because you have to stay in or you have all these restrictions and guidelines that you have to follow? Everyone does. Everyone is practicing social distancing. They're wearing the face mask. They're even wearing face masks when they're in the cars by themselves, the windows rolled up, and driving. No one's looking around, but everybody's staying focused. Are you staying focused, or has fear set in? So we're going to be reading about Psalm 121 today. But let me show you some things that you've been seeing in the news. Okay, the news is completely covered with information about COVID-19. You see it everywhere. You even see information about how many people are in the hospitals or how many people are have recovered or how many deaths there are. You see it not only for states, but you can see it for the whole nation. And there, everywhere you go, everywhere you turn, you're still seeing information about COVID-19. Have you tried to block it all out? Have you tried to say, I've heard enough? Have you turned the TV and the news off so that you don't have to hear anymore? Well, let's keep going. Okay, I've transitioned out onto my deck to be outside in the fresh air and the sunshine. And one thing that I did read in all the information that they're putting out, not that I've read it all, thank God, is that being outside for a certain amount of time each day helps to strengthen your immune system so that you can fight this off. So usually every day I come out and I sit for a little bit and I just enjoy the peace and quiet. And then of course, all the trees and everything that's surrounding me. But what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be looking at Psalm 121. Okay, so Psalm 121 says, I will lift up my eyes to the mountains. From whence shall my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to slip. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun will not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will protect you from all evil. He will keep your soul. The Lord will guard your going out and your coming in, from this time forth and forever. 21 has a lot of figurative language, like mountains. What do mountains represent? Mountains represent problems, obstacles, COVID-19. Those are the things that we're facing. Then, it talks about the eyes. Right here. The eyes are the lamp of the body. To be single vision, not to be blurred or doubled. So let's look at some verses on mountains and eyes. The verse that I have on mountains is Isaiah 52:7. Isaiah 52:7 says, how lovely on the mountains are the feet of him who brings good news, who announces peace, who brings good news of happiness, who announces salvation, and says to Zion, your God reigns. COVID-19 is a mountain right now. Are you bringing good news to those that are around you? Are you announcing peace, or are you talking fear? Don't let fear grip your heart, because this is a time where fear is really building. And we don't want to let fear step in and take the place of what God's word has said. So you want fear to have no place. We go back to Psalm 119, verse 105. It says, thy word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. God's word has to be instilled in our hearts, so that we can, when we're in situations that are difficult, it doesn't even have to be COVID-19, it can be those obstacles, those problems that we're facing. God's word has to be the lamp unto our feet and the light to my path.
What do feet stand for?
Feet stands for stability, hospitality, and journeys. Stability, stand firm. Stand firm, because every place you put your foot, God has directed it. Hospitality, walking in kindness, serving others. Journeys is the same thing. Traveling. But where are your words going to travel? Where are your feet going to travel? What are your eyes going to look at? What are your eyes going to believe? Are you going to believe the word of the Lord? Or are you going to believe what the people are posting in the news? Are you going to let fear sit in? Or are you going to say, fear has no place here? So let's go back and look for hands. Ecclesiastes 9:10 says, whatever your hands find to do, verify. Verily, do it with all your might. For there is no activity or planning or wisdom in Sheol where you are going. Wow. So these people that they were talking about were not making good decisions. But whatever your hands find to do, do it with all your might. While you're at home during this time, what are you doing with your hands? Hands stand for approval, acceptance, love, and serving. Are you serving those around you? Or are you spending the time grumbling and complaining? Are you accepting the situation and making the most out of it? Or are you sitting down and just, why do we have to do this? So let's make some decisions here. Your mouth. Mouth reveals what's in your heart. Your mouth is like a rudder. It guides the ship. So I'm going to Ephesians 4:29. That says, let no unwholesome word proceed from your mouth, but only such a word as is good for edification, according to the need of the moment, that it may give grace to those here. So when you're talking and sharing with your friends on the phone, or sharing with your friends on FaceTime, or even in your classes when you're working in Google Meet or Zoom or one of those things, is your conversation building people up, or is it tearing them down? Is it guiding your ship in the direction God wants you to go? Or is it taking your ship all over the ocean with no direction at all? So let's look at this.
So look at James 3:10. Now let's do 9 and 10. Let's start with 8, 9 and 10. But no one can tame the tongue. It is a restless evil full of deadly poison. With it we bless our Lord and Father, and with it we curse men who have been made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come both blessings and curses. My brethren, these things ought not to be this way. Does a fountain send out from the same opening both fresh and bitter water?
So think about that. Are you talking and praising the Lord at one moment, and then the next moment you're grumbling and complaining and you're cursing and you're talking about other people? Because during this time, there's a lot of frustrations. There's a lot of intense conversations going on. And it can really, the words that you speak cannot be taken back. So we have to be careful what we're saying. Yes, we're frustrated. Yes, we don't want to be inside. But are we letting God, are we letting Him take and guide our thoughts and our tongue? Are we taking control? What have we done? So we have to think about that. So anyway, I have something I'd like to show you guys.
So here behind my house is this really steep hill that goes down into the woods, and it's really peaceful. And when it says, how lovely on the mountains are the feet of them that bring good news. When you walk up that hill, when you walk up the hill of your problems, When you walk up the hill of your frustrations, are your eyes looking to the Lord? See, right here at the top, there's a single tree. Are your eyes looking to the Lord? Are you letting Him help you? Or are you looking down at the bottom of the hill where your frustrations are? Where all the problems are, where the fear is. Or are you going to come up this hill? How lovely on the mountains are the feet of men. Walk up the hill. Walk up the hill of faith. Walk away from fear and come up to the hill, top of the hill. And bring good news. Bring good news to those friends around you.
You guys, you have the strength to do this. We all do. It's not just the children. And it's not just the adults, it's everybody. But we have to let go of fear, and we have to let God, because fear has no place here. It can't control us, because Jesus died on the cross so that we can be set free. We want to be set free. We want to walk in that freedom. We don't want to walk in the bondage. We want to be able to climb the mountain and to know that we have been set free. Okay, I've come back in, sitting in my chair in my classroom, but I want to read Psalm 121 again. I will lift up my eyes to the mountains. From whence shall come my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to slip. He who keeps you will not slumber. He's not going to sleep through all this. God is wide awake, and He's working on our behalf. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun will not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will protect you from all evil. He will keep your soul. The Lord will guard your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forever. And that's what I pray for each one of you. That the Lord will guard your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forever, because He is going to keep you. God is faithful to His word. He is not a God who lies. He is a God who is faithful to His word, and He will perform it. And I certainly believe that He's doing the same for you guys. Love you guys. Miss you. And I pray that you all just have joy in your heart and let fear have no place. Love you. Bye.